in June, actually, for the adult bereavement programs. Mm-hmm. For volunteers who are interested in working with bereaved adults and providing support either in support groups or one-to-one. We do some one-to-one visits both in the community and here at the hospice residence. Volunteers in the gardens, we also at the Second Story Treasures thrift store in Walnut Grove, and then our special events are which are growing, it seems, since I got here. So we work with the West Fine Art Show, which is an annual art show we do in the summer or early fall. We have the garden party that we do in August. The Plates and Glasses is new, but we are up and coming is the annual butterfly release we have at Crosbury Farms, yeah, which is just spectacular.
We've got little ones to take to it. They release a butterfly.
Yeah. This year it's
Yeah, Painted Ladies are being released this year. It's on July 8th, and so we do face painting and craft activities, but it's for all ages. And it's people come to release a butterfly in honor or in memory of a loved one, or just because. Crosbury Farms has been great. They actually have planted different things that the butterflies really enjoy, so that the butterflies actually stick around for... they sent us a photo where they still had butterflies 2 weeks later, which is often unheard of. So, yeah, great space there, and they've been good to us. They donate the use of the space and support the event each year. Lots of ways to get...
And they have volunteers for the office.
Yeah, we have office volunteers and our...
The garden ones.
Yeah, the garden. And a Celebrate a Life campaign that we do at the mall each year for... It's a memorial tree. And we have volunteers that do, I think it's 3-hour shifts at the mall. For the 2 weeks leading up to Christmas. So we finish it off around the 15th or 17th because that's, well, the parties start before that, but people become less available because of travel, etc. So, lots of different ways to. And we have our board, both our foundation and society boards, and right now we of course have a new residence fundraising committee. So we are hosting two VIP events in May, a breakfast meeting and in a wine and cheese, just to introduce the new residents and how the community can get behind it and provide support through the purchase of medical equipment or soft furnishings. And we really are talking about it in terms of making our house a home, so which your contribution will certainly help with. We receive funding through the province of BC, I'm sure you've heard, in a $5 million grant through the BC Housing and...
Fraser Health.
So $3 million from the BC Housing and $2 million from Fraser Health. And then in addition to funds that we've raised and different requests that we've received, we have enough to break ground in summer and is the hope. But we're looking to raise an additional $1 million to, we're really talking about it in making our house a home. It's all the things that will make the difference between a building and a home for patients and their families near the end of life. So we're excited.
Did you see the plans?
Yeah, we can show you.
We kind of looked and we were wondering how many beds.
15
beds.
Yeah, I'll show you when we go back in.
Yeah, please.